From the moment I opened up my eyes, there's one thing that stays on my mind. The love her show with the duo. You gotta love her, praise her, treat her right. Let your life reflect all the beauty that's inside of you. You gotta love yourself, let the best of you shine through.
Welcome to the Love Her Show with the Duo.
Hey, lovers, welcome back. I'm Kelly Fisher.
And I'm Tana Gilmore.
And together, we're the matchmaking duo. Wow, another week.
Another week. This is the podcast where we discuss all things love, life, business, and bliss.
Yes, and we are so excited. I mean, I know we say this every week, but we are so excited to be back. You just don't even know.
Sometimes, y'all, it's a struggle even making it, I'm telling you.
I know.
But we get it done. We get here.
Yeah, but I mean, by the time we do get a chance to unwind and get a chance to talk to all of you, it really is uplifting. So don't think, sometimes we travel and people are like, oh, you know, we love to listen to your podcast, but believe me, we love to share with you as much as you love to come on. So
we do, but we have to take, you know, special time out of the week and out of the day to be able to get it done. So, but again, we love doing this, and we love radio. We love talking. Mm-hmm. It's almost like we're on the phone anyway, but it's just, you know, we're talking with all of you.
I know. I feel like we're all in one big room and just chatting away.
Yeah. So pull up. If you're in the car, keep driving, keep looking forward. If you're at home listening, grab a, you know, a cup of chai tea or a cup of cappuccino or a glass of wine or water or juice or whatever you're drinking, and tune in.
Yes, indeed. So we are back. We are back.
Yeah, it's episode 33. Woo, mm-hmm. We are matriculating right along.
We are. I think we should do some type of celebration for episode 50.
Oh, yes. Yeah, we'll do something special.
Episode 50. I'm going to make a note of that. Episode 50, we're going to do something special.
Yeah, we don't know yet. We'll figure it out. But yeah, that would be great.
Or send us some...
Some ideas. Yeah, because that's a milestone.
I know.
That's
we're celebrating with
weeks.
You.
Yeah, that's 50 weeks of programming.
Maybe we'll do like a little event or get together if we can. Of course, I'm over.
Oh my gosh.
Overachieving. But it would just be so nice to have everybody come together,
All in podcast. Maybe for episode 100.
Podcast land.
Not 50, not
that's
50.
Another like, what, how many weeks?
That's too much.
17
we're
weeks.
Doing too much.
That might be the end of the year.
Yeah, that's doing too much. No. So you can probably expect an event, probably episode 100. 100.
We shall see.
We're always trying to do something.
No, it'll just be nice. We'll see. Okay, somewhere between 50 and 100.
Oh, my goodness. We'll
get
okay,
there.
Okay, 75.
75?
No, not
that's all part of negotiation.
That's this duo here.
So what's new with you, Tana?
What is new? Gosh. Well, I enjoyed my weekend. My husband went away to one of our sons at West Point, and so it's his senior night. He's a senior. So he will be graduating next year. Woo-hoo. Yes, that's great.
So
he was there. I didn't make it because we were just coming off a plane from traveling from New York last week. And so, you know what? I watch movies. I caught up with all my shows. It might seem boring to you all, but for our life is so busy and, you know, we're on the go consistently. So it's nice to be able to sit in your recliner and be able to eat your favorite food or whatever and catch up on your shows. Mm. I mean, that is like, it may seem boring. They're like, oh my God, are you serious?
No, I think a lot of people.
I was so excited. I had the time of my life just to be able to do that. I slept on the couch. It was great.
That's so funny.
That's great.
That is so funny. No, I think a lot of people can relate.
Alone? I mean, you know, we're empty nesters. So I'm like, whew. Yeah, it was great. Simple pleasures. Simple pleasures. Well, what about
you? Glad you enjoyed that. I'm trying to think. This weekend, well, we both went
to an
event. So we went to one of our mentors. She owns a business called Paradigm 360. And she had an event honoring one of her mentors. And I think it was just nice to get together and hear how, because she's such an awesome mentor to us, and then just to hear the backstory of how her mentor started with her when she was age 10.
Yes.
And, you know, followed her along. It just really, I think one of the things that inspired me to do is just to, you know, give back even more.
Mm-hmm.
Even though, you know, Tana and I are definitely at the point where we lean on other women who are further along than we are. But I mean, I think still being intentional about looking back to see who you can help. I mean, we're always at one step ahead of someone else in some area. So I think that really encouraged me to see who else can I pour into or help in some way. Because I know when someone's helped me, you know, it really has just lifted a burden. So
it really does. And so I think that we both give back to certain, you know, charities and organizations, but we wouldn't be where we are today if somebody didn't really help us and push us along and believe in us. So we're looking forward to it. And I'm sure we'll make a major announcement when we are able to adopt a new business, because that's on our vision board too, mm-hmm. as a business, where we're looking to adopt a business and be able to pour and sow into that woman's new business as someone did for us.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, and there's different things to do, like even paying it forward. I remember I was in when I first, got divorced and moved to Charlotte, and it was just a bad day. You know, you just have one of those days when mm-hmm. just nothing goes right. I think my kids were just not listening. You know, we had gone to Chick-fil-A. I had transitioned from a new business, so my money wasn't mm-hmm. quite right. My money was kind of funny. But it wasn't funny. So right. They wanted Chick-fil-A. I went through the drive-thru, and someone just paid for me. Yes. Oh my gosh, I was so, of course I called Tana, I was like, oh my, I was in tears that someone paid for me. So I mean, I think that all of us can do, even if it's just this week, just pay it forward in some way, whether it's paying for someone, you know, through a drive-thru, whether it's calling up someone that you know you can help in some way, or just reaching out to someone that you know that you can help.
Yes.
So that was something that I took away from this weekend.
That was a highlight of what I had taken away from that, and just to be around so many influential women of power that share the same or have shared the same struggles as we have as a woman-owned business in, a relatively new business. This is year four for us. But, just some of the things that we can do differently in our business, and just to be able to watch these women and to know that they've done it and we can do it too. So it was a push for me as well.
Sure. So I know that last week we were talking about some of the things to do to know when to cut friendships and relationships mm-hmm. off, wasn't it?
That was something.
That was something.
And it's so crazy because as we embarked on that journey and to talk about it, it seems like everywhere we went, when we were in New York, people were like asking us about that specific piece. Like, where do I meet new people? Like friendships, like where do I go? And mm-hmm. it's like, well, this is a thing, you guys. This is a real thing right here.
It is. And it was on our vision board anyway, mm-hmm. as something to expand our business to. So mm-hmm. we're, moving toward that way, just, another thing to add value to our clients mm-hmm. and followers. So it's funny that it kept coming up, but,
just confirmation.
Yeah. Confirmation, which we love.
Yes.
So we said, okay, we're going to do a part two of this week. Okay. So we know who to leave alone, when to cut the cord, but mm-hmm. where do you go to find authentic connections and friendships? So where do you go? So we've cut everyone that doesn't need to be around, but what can you do? So I think first of all, what we found, and I know what I found in my own walk, and the many clients that come to us, we have to even just start from step one. You have to be open to the possibility that there are people out there who just might be worthy of your trust.
Mm-hmm.
So that's before we even look around or see who's out there, because it comes from a place of being vulnerable and thinking, okay, there might just be, I have a small circle now, but maybe I could be open to having new friends, and maybe I can be open to finding that there are people out there that just might make a good friend.
It's so funny. This is so funny because we have some friends that we call them like a side joke, and they know we're teasing them, but hashtag no new friends.
Yeah.
Hashtag no new friends. So it's interesting because I think that the older we get, a lot of times the more closed off we are to inviting new people in our lives. And so what we don't want you to do that, listeners, we don't want you to be closed off to meeting amazing people. It's so much easier when you're seven. You meet somebody at the park and they're your best friend, or, oh, my new sister, or my new, I think about your daughter.
Oh, yeah.
She's like going to be seven next week. And it's so funny because her and the little neighbor across the street, she's like, oh, we're sisters. And that, and of course, her daughter's, African-American, the little neighbor is a Caucasian, and they have no idea what color they are.
They're
like, oh, we're sisters. This is my sister. I mean, they just meet friends like that all the time. And I wish that we can be like that as a society today. I don't feel like there is a reason why we can't be, but I think we are getting in our own way of not being open enough to allow people to come in and being able to trust. I mean, how many times do we hear that from clients?
That's true. That's true. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I love their friendship. I just look back and just smile because I'm like, I wonder how long that is going to last,
before
different things come into play, or they realize, oh, we're different colors, or, mm-hmm. But for right now, they are the best of friends. And so I think maybe if we can even go back to that, but I think also it just takes effort. So a lot of times, are even the people that we were talking about that said hashtag no new friends, and I was in that category myself. Yes,
you were. Hashtag no new friends.
No, because you know what? I was. But it takes effort. It really takes effort to even invite other people, because then you have, like, you feel like, okay, it's going to be the ups and downs, the dramas, and you're taking on other people's problems and all that. But
get to know them.
Oh, no. It's almost like a first date. Like, tell me about yourself.
It's like, ugh.
Do you know how much I have on my plate?
I don't feel like talking about me or you.
No. But I think, you know, even for me, the friendships that I've built, you know, I've had friendships from all the way back in elementary school and high school forever. But the new friendships that I've built have really been just without any effort. So you just kind of see who has things in common with you. And then you can start from there. So whether you just like to hike, whether you like to swim. I know Tana met some new friends with wanting to learn how to swim.
Yeah, I did. So it's interesting because I go back to dating myself. So when I turned 40,
yesterday,
just a few days ago, I decided that I wanted to do a triathlon, and that I, but the problem was I didn't know how to swim. So I'm like, you know what? Enough is enough. And I almost drowned in Cabo 1 year. And so I was like, you know what? This is a year I'm going to learn how to swim. I'm not going on vacation and not knowing how to swim. So I put a Facebook post out to say, hey, anybody interested in a triathlon? Anyone interested in learning how to swim? I can bike already. I run already. But I can't swim. And so 9 women contacted me. I'm in. So we hired a coach, and he coached us to swim. And so if you think about it, we shared the same fear of deep water. We shared the same fear of failure. We shared so many different things, but we are still friends today, and we're very close. I mean, we just were at somebody's, our friend's birthday parties a couple of weeks ago. Kelly and I mentioned that we were there, but you know, it's interesting because we all learn together, but now we share that. And so I consider some of these women friends, and I love them just as much as I do some friends that I've known from high school.
Mm-hmm.
So you can create that bond with new people in your life.
Yeah. And I think one of the things that holds us back to making new friends is that we feel like, okay, this friend is going to have to know my deepest, darkest secrets, and, you know, I have to open up to the nth degree, you know, as I did with my other friends. But, I mean, what we've learned is that there are different levels to connections and friendships. So, I mean, there's some that you can just enjoy their company. I mean, there are some that you can support each other in business. I mean, we have, you know, friends that we kind of come together and plan our businesses together and, you know, forecast different things and help each other. You can connect on a shared hobby, like Tana said, bike riding or swimming. I know for me, if someone, you know, usually, you know, you can hit it off with someone and have a conversation. And I think if you make a list, or if you just have in mind some of the things that you are passionate about or that are big things in your life. So for me, anyone who is a solo parent or a single parent and, you know, making things happen in the world, of course, we're going to have that connection.
Mm-hmm.
Loving classical music. I love classical music, but that's not something that you hear all the time.
No,
so,
and especially not women of color.
No. So there was a speaker at my church who actually was classically trained in piano. So I had to make my way over there to have a conversation with him. And we had such a great conversation about, you know, classical music and some of the, you know, how his journey was in it. And of course, I'm a violinist. Well, I was. And so just, you know, being able to connect on those things, and then families or children with life-threatening illnesses. I mentioned that my daughter is a cancer survivor. So anything around that, we'll probably end up having a conversation. Growing up in New Jersey or the Northeast, I live in the South now, but if anyone mentions, you know, I'm from New Jersey, obviously, you know, we're going to have a connection there. And then my sorority, or, you know, my HBCU. So I went to Florida A&M University. I could be online, I could be talking to different people, and obviously that's an instant connection. So I think if you make a list of things that are prominent in your life, you'll find people just along the way that you'll have some things in common with, and that would be a good foundation to start a very basic foundational friendship.
It really, that's a great idea. So we would recommend that you, again, take out a piece of paper if you can, and just write down those buckets. Buckets, and put them in categories. But like in an A category, we do a lot of that in our coaching. A category, B category, C category. An A category would be priority. So something that would, you know, take precedence over something else. So you know, something that you're very passionate about, like your top two things that you really want to focus on and connect with other people with. And then B category would be your subcategory, and C is something that you can do with or without, but you'd like, you have some level of interest maybe later.
Right.
So do that and see where you go with it. Also, we would recommend, once you do that, we would say meetup.com is amazing.
Oh yeah, we love Meetup.
We love Meetup. And so it's an amazing, you know, website to go and find clubs of like-minded people. So yes, you lose a few friends along the way, but you can certainly replace them. And this is a surefire way to do it. It's interesting because, you know, I talk about my Meetup page, and I just went through my Meetup page yesterday, and every once in a while I'll go through and see if I still have the same interest. And sometimes I delete some groups that I've never visited the Meetup group.
Many of us are just on the roll. Yeah. We're like, I thought it was a good idea.
I thought it was a good idea at the time. I've never gone to this Meetup group ever. So let me just get out of this thing.
Sorry to all the Meetup coordinators.
Exactly.
We apologize.
I should have sent an apology note yesterday as I was deleting myself from some groups, but I added some great ones. And so I have some new interests this year. So I haven't even shared, but I am like taking German classes online. Mm-hmm. So I have a grandson. He's 3. He's Dominic. He needs a bell.
And she's directing me for a bell.
He needs a bell. You guys, go to my social media page.
Because
I love
him.
He is so cute. So he lives in Germany. Yes, he lives in Germany.
Love
so,
him.
You know, I usually go get him once a year and he'll come over for 4 or 5 weeks. But he's now 3 and he's, you know, and German is his first language. And so he speaks a little bit of English, but you know, it's very difficult. I have a fear of not being able to communicate with my grandson. And so if somebody has to do something about it, I'm the adult here. So I can, you know, I can try to learn the language. And so that's what I'm doing. But what I did is I enrolled myself into 2 German speaking meetup groups. And so they just get together socially. It's a group where, you know, everybody's speaking German. They're helping you to learn the culture, learn the language. They're doing things together, just learning about German culture. Because the reality is, you know, my son and his mother are no longer engaged. So he may not live here in the U.S. I would love for him to, but I need to be able to communicate with my grandson.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm going to a meetup group next week. You know, with my German friends that I've never met.
Mm-hmm.
And my husband's like, do you know these people? Nope.
Well, that's the whole point
of
Meetup.
Nope. But they're now my new German friends. So I will be at this vineyard. We're going to this wine tasting, this vineyard with my new German friends. And we're going to try to speak German.
Hey, I love it. So on the next podcast, we want you to say one statement in German.
I will.
We need a new sentence.
I will open it up in German.
Yeah.
So that's my goal for 2018. By the end of 2018, I want to speak the language fluently so I can be able to communicate with my baby.
Oh, that's great. I think all I know is what, pregnancy Deutsch?
I don't even know what that
is. Okay. Well, Is that German? You all let me know. Yes, I think it's, do you speak Dutch or German?
Dutch,
maybe I'm not even German, Lord.
Yeah, but they do speak some, you know, Dutch. And
yes,
German.
That must be, yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, well, you get back to us and let us know, because that will be interesting
to
follow.
Yes.
But that's a great point. So just even digging deep and finding some things that you know, may not be something that you normally do,
mm-hmm.
but that would be a good value to add to your life.
Mm-hmm.
So that could be something that you can add to your list. So that's a great point. I think also, I'm at a point where I think a lot of our clients have mentioned this to us too. At a point in my life where I want to learn from others around me. So I want to have, you know, people around me who can add some things that I don't know, like even having a conversation about something that's totally off the wall, but that I never knew.
Mm-hmm.
Is always good. And I think a lot of our clients always like to have, I would just say, smart people around them.
Yes.
Not even mm-hmm. people in the same industry, because that's like, you do that every day.
Yeah, you get tired of talking to the same
right.
The
so
same
if you're
stuff.
A lawyer, do you really want to be
no.
surrounded with lawyers all the time?
No.
Yes. But I mean, how fun would it be to have a good friend that's like a jazz artist or something,
mm-hmm.
you know, just something a little different. So to your point, Tana, I think it's nice to be able to go to things that you don't have any knowledge of, but you can learn different perspectives from people who are, you know, on different walks of life.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I mean, I think one of the things that we did last year or this year, you know, we started joining other groups. So we've joined women's networking groups. I know Odyssey is having In the Black.
Yes.
Odyssey Network we belong to. So, and that brings together a whole lot of, you know, upwardly mobile women, but in doing all types of different things. So look in your area to see, you know, not just the regular everyday women's networking groups. Of course, they can be a little stuffy. I'm sorry. It can be
yes,
a little stuffy.
You know. You
but just look for something different that you can join, where you might be able to meet some people that can just add something that you didn't already know. And what else did we do? We went to Martha's Vineyard.
Yes, we went to Martha's Vineyard. And that was the first for us, the first of many, because we will be back.
Well, that's our new happy place.
Yes, that's our happy place, yeah. Martha's Vineyard. So, yeah, we met so many other people that are rowing the same way. Mm-hmm. So if you think about this, where are you going in your life? And what's your end goal?
Right.
So think about where you're trying to go.
And where are those people?
Yes, and where are those people? So mm-hmm. the people that we're trying to go, some of them are in Martha's Vineyard.
Yeah.
And so in clusters and groups and in these private homes and private invitation parties, that's where we're rolling.
Yeah.
You know, so that's where we're going. And we're going to be where they are.
Right. And even for fun. I mean, we've done some fun things. Of course, we were speaking at the same time, but yes. as writers for Essence, .com, you know, we go to Essence Festival every year. That is a huge place to meet
yes,
people and
is.
Just to
it's
really,
so
you know, sit in your hotel lobby, and there's always entertainment in the lobby.
Yes,
and,
we always meet
Hey, just
people.
Lobby watching is fun. Mm-hmm. We meet all kinds of people. So Essence Festival, but things like that. I would say also the gym, things as simple as the gym. We always say, it's so funny how many of our clients or, you know, followers or single people who are just looking for love are like, oh, yeah, I belong to a gym, but it's women, all women.
Well, if you're trying to meet your female friends, though, if you're trying to, you know, meet new friends, I would yes, say yes.
But we're doing double duty.
Yes.
How many of us like to be able to multitask? Can I get a bell?
Hallelujah.
That is something that you can multitask on. So, yes, we're trying to meet friends, but we can meet female friends and male friends, right? I mean, you don't have to be surrounded by women. Men make great friends, too.
I mean, and side note, ladies. So I was at the gym this morning. So again, I go through this whole phase where, okay, I'm going to get up and I'm going to go to the gym and work out. So I was there at about 5:45 this morning, and I counted, and just my walking in, 7 men with their suits walking in. They had on their gym clothes walking in. That was right before me. So that was over the course of a 5-minute period.
Mm-hmm.
So 7 men before me walked in. So they're professional because they're going to work out, and then they're taking the shower. They're putting on their suit and they're going to work.
Right.
So if you all are missing out, if you're not at the gym in the morning, I'm
well,
telling
we
you
we always
now,
say what, between 5 and 7 a.m.
5 and 7 a.m. is where you need to be.
That's sure
And they
is.
Were in droves this morning. I couldn't even get a parking spot.
Oh,
I was
yeah.
like, this should be a shame that all these people are up.
And the early bird gets the worm.
That's
Those
right.
are the ones who are up and they're ready to move
yes.
and shake. So that's where you want to be.
Yes.
So you're killing 3 birds. You're meeting great women. You're meeting possibly a great man.
Great man. Mm-hmm.
And you're around a lot of other movers and shakers that, you know, could have some type of different outlook on life than you do. That might be fun.
And then you're getting in shape.
And
you know,
yes.
so you're staying healthy, which is going to help.
Which
you
is
going to
help you overall. Yes, definitely.
So yes, a great, great place
yes.
to connect and reconnect with people. And also you know, don't forget about those classes. You know, I was in had taken a cardio strength class this morning, and you know, I ended up seeing someone that I joined another organization that I'm affiliated with. It's called Young Lives, and we mentor teen moms because I was once a teen mom. But so, you know, I saw a couple of the ladies there. I'm like, oh my God, how long have you been coming here? I mean, again, it just strengthens the camaraderie,
right? Yeah,
so
I mean, you
great.
Don't want to always spend a whole lot of time on the treadmill. Definitely the treadmill is great, but you do want to just spend a little more time either before or after the treadmill to get a good class
mm-hmm.
in. And it's funny, I was thinking about one time when I went to the gym and I hadn't been in quite some time and decided, okay, I didn't know what the schedule was. So I just went up to the class and I was like, oh, you know what? I think I'm going to join this one. This one just started. Come to find out, it is Extreme Fitness. It was like Extreme Fitness number 2. It was like the
oh
top of the
God,
line. So this
hilarious.
Woman came in there and she had us running outside the room and coming back around and picking up stuff. And I mean, I was almost on the ground.
Is that the day that you couldn't walk out?
Yes, I couldn't walk for like a week. But you know what? One thing I will say is a lot of the people in there came up to me afterwards and they were like, congratulations, because we all thought that you were going to bail. So many people come into this class
Hilarious.
And bail. And so, of course, I'm the one who didn't read anything and just said, I'm going to join it. But you know what? I was thinking about it. Had I continued going to that class, all those people, had I continued, which I did not, can I get a bell? Because I couldn't walk for about 2 weeks.
I remember.
I didn't need to be in extreme fitness too. Not on my first day back. However, when we talk about friendships and connections, had I continued back, do you think that those people would have been really good friends of mine?
Yes.
Because they are regulars. They were like, we thought you were going to bail. You get points. And
yes.
We can't wait to see you next time. Haven't seen me since.
I know, but they show up. They're the same people that show up every week. You know, they show up, you know, if it's 2 or 3 times a week, they show up every week. So again, you look forward to seeing those same people.
Definitely.
Again, you get to build those connections. So this podcast is all about how to reintroduce new people into your life, you know, provided the ones that you got rid of.
Oh, gosh, I'm laughing because I didn't know the whole time they were looking at me, waiting for me to bail.
Say the heck with this. Yes. I'm peace. I'm out.
And I hung in there for what reason? Because I was out of commission for quite some time.
And so there's a couple other places that I think that would be very interesting and great for you all to attend. So the alumni chapters of any sorority, fraternity, those for sure. But then if you think about, you know, the NBA, the National NBA Association, those conferences, the tech conferences, those things like that, that whatever you're affiliated with, we want you to go to some of those and not go just for the information, but you want to network and you want to meet people, because guess what? All those people are in there for the same reason that you are.
Right.
So again, that's all, you already share a commonality. So we want you to be intentional about meeting. So the next time you go, we're going to challenge you all to meet 3 new people and keep in contact with 3 new people. We don't care if you got rid of some friends or not. It's still, you're adding them to your portfolio, your friend portfolio.
Right.
So add and connect with 3 new people. Get their contact information. Not just take their card, but we want you to reach out to them and say,
right,
it was really nice meeting you. As if it were an interview. It was really nice meeting you. I really enjoyed this. Let's connect for coffee. Or you know what? Let's spend some time on the phone or whatever, because you are crafting and developing a relationship.
Yeah. And I think it's important to make sure that you segue the relationship on those instances more to a personal level. So you can even just say, when you reach out to them and just say, hey, you know, oh my gosh, I'm still thinking about that awesome purple dress you had on. That was so amazing. You know, that's my favorite color. So you're not, again, following up like, oh, you know, this tech speaker was, you know, over the top. I learned A, B, and
that.
C. We're trying to you know, make friendships. So
yes,
we know how to network on a business level.
Exactly.
I think all the travel movements, too. There's so many different travel sites. But, I mean, I think we've been noticing, you know, even the sailing groups, you know, that's becoming really popular.
Yes.
Just getting together and going on a boat with a lot of different people to some amazing locations throughout the world. So again, you're killing a million birds with one stone by meeting new friends, people who like to travel. You're going to a destination that you hadn't gone to before, and then you're all coming back with those experiences. So why would you not stay in touch? Of course you're going to stay in touch as long as you make the effort to stay connected when you leave.
I mean, and if you think about it, I love the Yacht Week. So if you think about how many of us really sail? You know, how many of us sail? I mean, like, that level
really
of sailing.
Really sail, yeah.
Yeah, that, no, so we're not talking about
a carnival cruise.
We're not talking about a carnival cruise. We're not talking about Royal Caribbean.
Yes,
we've done that. But no. We're talking about, like, really, like, renting a yacht, you know, getting a chef, getting, you know, a captain, and sailing.
Mm.
That's, I mean, those are the types of relationships that we want. Those are the type of things that we're doing. So,
yeah.
And so if you think about it, you all share that. It's a small percentage of population in this world that actually do it. So again, you're sharing those bonds. So
right,
you have no choice but to create friendships. And so, because so the next time that you think about being on the boat or sailing, you're thinking about that person that you met in Croatia or wherever. I mean, they have a huge population, a sailing population in Croatia.
They do, yes. But I mean, I think we're just getting to the point where why not? Why
not?
I mean, can we get a bell for why not? All right, lovers out there, why not?
Yeah, just do it.
Just do it. Yeah. Do something fun and then also be able to meet some other people. I would say one last place, and there's so much, we could probably go on forever. Mm-hmm. One last place that I've met a lot of new friends is social media. So, I mean, I don't know that there are any rules. I probably do my own thing. But if there's someone that I've followed for a while and I just love their content or something, or I just keep seeing their posts and it just either inspires me or uplifts me or it feels, you know, a certain way, I probably send them a friend request. I've had people send me a friend request. Don't know them from Adam. Of course, yeah. We have some mutual people in common, but I don't know them. And then after a while, as we start liking each other's posts and, you know, having little comments, you feel like you know them.
Yes.
So you build different friends that are rowing the same way, even through social media, which is a very easy thing to do. And you'll realize that a lot of people will accept your friend request just as much as you, hopefully, would accept theirs if their content is something that you feel would add value to your life.
I mean, it's interesting because we've met some amazing people just from social media. A lot of our relationships that we have now, they started out like, you know, professional and, you know, but now they're personal and now, you know, we're friends.
Right. So I can't even tell you half the people that, you know, we're friends with on social media that I don't even know where we met. You know,
I have no idea where we met them.
I couldn't say, but, you know, they're regulars and, you know, we comment on each other's, you know, children's birthdays and, you know, different accomplishments.
Especially when they wear something cute or some show-stopping heels. Be like, girl, those heels are everything.
I know. So, and then, you know, by the time you finally do meet, you're like, oh my gosh, I feel like we already know each other.
Definitely.
So that's another place that we can certainly go. So we can go on forever, but I think the whole point over here, just to wrap it up, is that first of all, you have to be open to the possibility of meeting new friends. So if you've been one of those hashtag no new friends, let's start there. Opening up your heart to the possibility of meeting some awesome, amazing new people.
Yes. You can do it.
Yes.
You can do it. So indeed. Just pretend that you're 7 years old again.
Yes.
And everybody's your friend.
Yes. And you are my daughter and her friend Julia. Yeah, and they don't know the difference.
They have no idea that they're black.
Oh, my God. They're holding hands.
They're hugging.
Oh my gosh, by the
time they're wearing each other's clothes. They're sharing each other's clothes
and stuff,
dressing up in each other's
clothes. Louise revisited.
So cute.
Yeah, I know. I know. Who will be the one to be like, wait a minute, we don't have much in common, but you do.
Yes, you do.
You do.
They are sisters.
We want you to go out and get some new Louises, all of you Thelmas out there. Invite. I know we have a lot of male followers too, so. Hopefully this has inspired you. So why not go out, do some things, open your heart, get out there and go to some different places that you hadn't thought of and live.
And share with us, please. Share with us, you know, the challenge. So we charged you with meeting three new people.
Three new friends
and staying in contact with them. And so send us an email.
Send
us an inbox on our social media page, the Matchmaking Duo. And our social media pages are The Matchmaking Duo at Facebook, at Matchmaking Duo at Twitter, The Matchmaking Duo at Instagram, and our website is thematchmakingduo.com. So you have so many ways to contact us and let us know how things are going, because we want you to connect with new people.
We do. And you know what? I haven't really been able to ring the bell at all. Can I just ring it for
just
no reason?
Ring the darn bell for no reason. Ring the bell. Woo! She almost had a fit because she couldn't find the stupid thing. I can't find my bell.
Bell is so torn up.
It's been all over the country.
So Santa's like, I think we should just order more than one bell. I'm like, no. This is the bell that started it all. Not. I don't even know where it came from. It's
not
so
even
going to
ring
up.
Anymore. It's not.
But it was there from
episode
one.
Ding.
Yeah.
Ding.
Have a wonderful day, everyone.
Bye.
And we will talk to you next week. Have an amazing week. Bye.
I've had to love her to embrace the love inside of you. Because there were only